You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It is already Tuesday. It's Tuesday, the 27th day of January, 2015. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be live here, Lord willing, for the next 3 hours, and we have a jam-packed transmission. We have a whole bunch of different guests joining us. We have the man responsible for putting, I guess it's going to be more than 50 billboards up around the United States the last year, promoting Infowars.com and this radio show, and that spurred other people who were trying to discover their identities, if they want the attention, who are copying him and putting him up as well. Now hundreds and hundreds of billboards as we speak in almost every city of the United States except where I live. I've had affiliates before three different times by billboards, but it is strange that they say a prophet is not known in his own country. I'm not saying I'm a prophet, but the saying certainly goes to that, when you actually live in a town or a place, people don't take you as seriously as, say, people in other cities, other states, other countries. Or maybe the listeners just think, hey, he's on the radio, so what? We don't need to wake anybody else up. I'm not complaining. It's just interesting human psychology. So he's popping in for about 10, 15 minutes. And then we've got Joseph Curl, who with the good graces a nice nod from Matt Drudge, created a kind of Republican-style, constitutionalist-style clone of the DrudgeReport.com on the Washington Post. And... or the Washington Times. I can't. A big difference. And it's called Right Read at the Washington Times. And Joe Curl's done a lot of work for Drudge for decades since it was first around when he was over at the Washington Times. So now we've got Joseph Curl from the WashingtonTimes.com, which he never left. He's just focusing on that now, joining us to give us his view on inside the Beltway. I mean, Joe Curl's been to the White House hundreds of times. He's got all the inside connections. I don't know if it's hundreds of times, but I know under Bush it was something like scores of times. And he's got a lot of different contacts. He's there every day, thousands of times at Capitol Hill and in the Beltway is my main point, over the last 30 years of covering politics. And he's going to give us his take on where the Republican leadership's really going to go. John Boehner, who will not repeal Obamacare, who will not try to prosecute Obama for any of his Benghazi crimes or the IRS gate, the NSA gate, the list goes on and on. He won't do anything about the open borders, treasonous policy that's taking place. We're going to find out from Joe Curl the inside Beltway scoop with his ear to the ground on what he thinks is coming in the future and a lot more. So we'll discuss the political realignment with Joe Curl of rightread.com, and that is linked up on the WashingtonTimes.com, a subdivision of that, and we'll put it back on screen for all the TV viewers out there. So that's coming up today with Joseph Curl. And then we've got Leanne McAdoo. Well, she comes on before Joe Curl joins us. She's going to be in studio with us. They've got a worldwide, people from all over the world are coming to it, an international conference going on here in Austin, Texas, on the threat of AI. And the head of Tesla and others are very, very concerned about AI machines taking over. And Leanne McAdoo was able to interview folks at the conference that's ongoing yesterday with our cameraman, Travis Knight, David Knight's son. We're going to get his take on what he saw as well. We're going to air some of those clips here. But a big report tonight on the Nightly News. This is just a preview coming up on this international move. AI has arrived as the Wired Magazine reports. In fact, we'll put that back on screen. AI has arrived, and that really worries the world's brightest minds. That's Wired reporting from the conference, Infowars.com. is reporting from the conference as well. Stay with us. I don't claim to speak for the people. I claim to speak for my interest, which are to be in an open, free society with checks and balances, a system and a society based and built around defending individual liberty, life, private property, and justice. And we know historically what works. We know time and time again that collectivism leads to all-out nightmarish enslavement and ruination. Again, we have a giant broadcast coming up today. Leanne McAdoo is at an international conference that's based here in Austin, Texas. It's being covered by Wired Magazine, the BBC, you name it. It is the biggest, basically, anti-AI conference pretty much ever held with top scientists. There's the headline, AI has arrived, and that really worries the world's brightest minds. And Leanne has been going there the last few days. She's going back as well. She's going to be joining us in studio today and has a bunch of the interviews that are going to be airing over the next few days on the nightly news. But she talked to the author of Artificial Intelligence, the book, of course, that was going to be made into a film by Stanley Kubrick, but was later made into a film after he died mysteriously. Artificial Intelligence was made into a film by Steven Spielberg. She talked to the author of AI and others. She's going to be joining us at the bottom of the second hour. Robert Brobe, who's a true trailblazer, has put up scores of huge billboards all over the United States, even though he's not really a rich man. We didn't know who he was the last 6 months, but just kept hearing about the billboards. They're all over the country, and now something interesting happened. Other people are imitating it, putting up similar billboards in their cities or in the same city. So a chain reaction is beginning, and we need to really get the artwork he has and get with our graphics department, as I said about a month ago, and just create the PDF files for Infowars.com and do the work for folks so they can just contact their local billboard company and put them up. I mean, now the billboard industry has collapsed for all intents and purposes because of the internet taking over, and also because of the fact that the economy is in trouble. So billboards that would cost $5,000 that are in major cities off major highways that hundreds of thousands of people will see a week, you can get those for basically the cost of the graphics, the cost of the message. We're talking $1,000, $2,000, and reach hundreds of thousands of people. We don't have the capital or the money to do this ourselves nationwide. But I am today, when I get off air, we're going to make the graphics in the graphics department. We're going to basically just imitate that one. And we are, I think it's excellent. And then we are going to create a page on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com where we're going to put different billboards up there. And you know what? It doesn't just have to be Infowars.com. We'll also have some just saying, remember when America was a free country, restore the republic, and then maybe... Well, I don't know who else's site we could link to. That doesn't really make sense. Maybe just have George Washington up there and say, remember when we wanted to build a free country? Doesn't mean we ever had one. We just wanted to build one. And those ideas did build the greatest experiment in liberty we've ever seen. We never got to the ultimate goal of a perfect utopia of freedom. But we wrote the book worldwide on what the standards of freedom, success, and prosperity are. Because out of freedom comes incredible prosperity. The problem is then great decadence, as we constantly warn and history shows. Incredible decadence then follows. The corruption moves in, then the tyranny to secure the ill-gotten gains of the insiders, who then wage jihad and war and a crusade, choose your word, on any independent wealth or ideas they do not control. That's the problem with letting hardcore corruption run rampant. You can have big mega bankers creating $2,000 trillion in fake derivatives and signing us on to it. But then if they catch an 18-year-old drinking a beer on his back porch, he'll be arrested. The system's all there to throw the book at people that have really done nothing wrong or victimless crimes, but then to exalt the great tyrants. They say, if you're going to steal, steal big. Don't steal $1,000, you'll go to the pen for 20 years. Steal $5 billion, and they'll make you king. And that is really the corruption that we're facing. Joseph Curl of the Washington Times has launched a powerful new section on the site, rightread.com. He formerly, of course, worked for about, I don't know, over a decade with Drudge Report, drudgereport.com. And the new site he's got has got the blessing of the big man, Drudge, Matt Drudge. And so we're going to get Joe Curl's take, as I said earlier, he just joined us, on will the Republican leadership get away with the unprecedented betrayal of the libertarian Tea Party movement that put them in power back in November in the House and Senate. Well, we now know it's open borders, certifying everything Obama's done as a dictator. He is a dictator in action. Doesn't mean he'll stay in office, just means he's operating as a dictator. Even Jonathan Turley and other liberals admit that. Three times worse than Bush, in his words, when it comes to eviscerating the Constitution.